Hello friends, welcome to Wisdom Simplified. I hope the earlier video lectures have helped you. Let's see what we are simplifying today. So the topic for today is input tax credit. Now what is input tax credit? You all know that we have one benefit in this GST regime, which is input tax credit. Now let's see the definition first. Input tax credit means setting off the amount of input tax against the amount of output tax. What exactly is input tax and output tax? Now, whenever you go in the market and you buy a product or you sell a product, you have to pay GST on it. Now, the GST that you pay while purchasing a product, that is input tax for you. And the tax that you are paying on the sales of a particular product, that is the output tax. Okay. Now, the same thing is explained here. You can read it. At the time of buying any product or availing any services, we pay taxes on it. Now, at the time of sale, we charge tax, and now we adjust input tax against output tax. After adjusting ITC, we pay the balance liability of tax to the government, and this mechanism is called utilization of ITC. So this thing that we do while paying the output tax, the adjusting of the input tax that we do is called the utilization of input tax credit. There's one example which says, see, suppose I'm a manufacturer and I have to pay 12,500 GST on my output sales. Okay, on sales I'm paying 12,500. And I've already paid 10,000 on the purchases for raw materials or whatever. So I've already paid 10,000. So the final amount that I'll be required to pay to the government will only be 2,500, because that's the benefit of ITC. You get the benefit of 10,000 that you've already paid. So eventually at the end of the day, you will pay 2,500. Okay. Now, there's one full-fledged example which will help you understand the entire chain, how the entire chain works. Now, what happens? Usually the producer of things are the person who are not required to pay any GST, because they are producing, means the raw material, like the farmers and everyone, those people are they are creating things, right, from the farm and everything. You get it automatically. So that's not really manufacture, or even if it is production, it is not really taxable for now, right? So they are not supposed to pay GST on that. So what happens? Suppose I'm a manufacturer of ready-made clothes. So I'll be first procuring the cottons and raw material and everything from a farmer. Okay, let's say I'm directly procuring it from a farmer. So if on that transaction, suppose I'm paying tax, I can take the credit for that when I go ahead and sell my final ready-made cloth. Okay, now suppose in this manufacturer, this is how it usually works, right? You'll get the credit for the earlier transaction that you have done, for the taxes that you've paid earlier. Now, just to cut short the process, I have started with a manufacturer and we are going through wholesaler, retailer and the consumer chain. So let's assume this manufacturer has his own farm and everything. So he's directly procuring things, he is making it everything in his own factory and all, and then finally he is giving it to the wholesaler. So what happens is, he will do all the working and everything, he'll add up his profit and everything, and suppose the sale price for him for the ready-made cloth comes out to be 400. Now what happens? On this 400, he will be required to tax 18% GST at 18%, which sums up to 72, and the total price that he will be charging to the wholesaler will be 472. Okay, now what he has to do is, he will charge that 72 from wholesaler, and he will be the person who will submit that 72 to the government as taxes, right? Now, when we go ahead, this 472 for the wholesaler, the value, the sale price, say suppose if he is doing some value addition on his part for whatever, maybe he is working on it or he might be adding his profit and all. So that value addition suppose comes out to 20%. Now this 20% of 400, okay? So the total sale price for him will be 480. Now what used to happen earlier is, under VAT and everything, we used to consider the 470, the price of 470, and the value addition was on 470. So if you can see, the 72, the element of that tax part was already getting repeated here, and it was again taxed, which is not correct, right? So that's why this GST came into the frame. And now what we do, we directly take the price, we ignore the tax, and on that whatever value additions are made, on that again the tax is calculated. Now again, see, the price comes to 480. And on 480, if you see, the 18% comes up to 86. And the price that wholesaler will charge to the retailer will be 566. Now that is the that's the price for the retailer. But now let's focus on the tax part and see how it works out. The tax part will be 86 is the tax that the wholesaler is required to pay, and that he has already collected from the retailer, right? But he had already paid 72 to the manufacturer, so he will get the credit for this 72. This 72 is the input tax credit, and 86 is the output tax for him in this particular situation. So the after utilization ITC, utilization of ITC, the total, the actual benefit, actual tax liability comes out to 14 rupees. So he will be liable to pay to the government this 14 rupees. Okay, now let's go ahead in the following change. And the retailer, the price for the retailer is 566, but again his value addition is going to be on 480, right? You're not supposed to consider the tax figure. The entire 86 will be reducted, and on that the value additions would be added, and then on the entire amount, whatever the comes, it comes out to be, on that the tax will be charged. Say it is 576, assuming that retailer is also doing 20% of value addition, it comes out to 576. And the GST comes out at 104, total being 680. So the final consumer here, he will be paid 680 rupees for the readymade garment. And the 680 has 104 rupees of total tax included in it. But there is no tax on tax happening in this, right? And therefore, out of this, in this situation for retailer, the output tax is 104, and the 86 that he had already paid to the wholesaler is for the input tax for him. So he'll minus the thing, and after that the balance liability of 18 rupees is the amount that he will be liable to pay to the government. And eventually the entire burden falls on the consumer, and the entire tax of 104 is eventually coming out of the pocket of the consumer. I hope I have explained it nicely. Thank you.